Here's a quick follow-up video to an earlier tutorial. REDxEYE has been hard at work on the SourceIO plugin. They've added one of the features I've received a lot of requests about: importing Source Filmmaker maps into Blender. Let me show you how it works. Before we begin, make sure you have the latest version of the SourceIO plugin for your version of Blender. Older versions of Blender, like version 2.79, are not supported. If your computer cannot run at least Blender 2.8, you should probably look into upgrading. On the GitHub releases page, I select the most recent version, choose the zip file for your version of Blender, and install it as you would with any add-on. Next, we download a map from sfmlab.com, or we use files downloaded from the Steam Workshop. In order to import maps, you will need to have a Source Engine game installed, as well as any content packs or mods that the map requires. Source Filmmaker or Gary's Mod are your best options. We install the map into our Source Filmmaker directory as normal. Now ready to import it into Blender. Open up Blender and empty your scene. The add-on can be a little bit buggy and slow, so we will open up the console window to monitor what the plugin is doing when we hit import. If you run into an error and decide to create an issue on the GitHub page, make sure to provide console output. This helps the developer figure out what's wrong with the plugin or your setup. Let's hit File, Import, Source Engine Assets, Source Map. Maps have the BSP extension. You can find them in the maps directory in your user mod folder. Navigate to and select the BSP file. The add-on will now read the file and in the process try to decide where to find all the materials and textures. If you get an error at this point, it is likely because the add-on has difficulty reading all the Source Engine mod directories. For me, the map imports pretty quickly. So let's take a look at what the plugin did. I'm gonna switch to the material preview mode and navigate around the scene. And immediately we notice something's off. It's only created the walls of the map. This is because of how the Source Engine maps work. Maps have the BSP extension because BSP stands for binary space partitioning. Without going into specific technical details, this is a way of storing simple level geometry. BSP geometry in a Source Engine map usually consists of the level ground, floors, walls, and utility walls that seal off the level. The actual models that usually add detail to a scene are stored in special entities. As you can see, SourceIO imported the BSP geometry into a single world geometry object and assigned the relevant materials to them. They imported lights into the light spot and light collections, and the rest of the entities are imported as empties. So how do we turn these empties into models? Well, in a BSP file, these entities refer to regular Source Engine model files that can be found in the Source Filmmaker model directory. And because this is SourceIO, we don't have to manually import them all. Let's take a look at the first static prop on the list. Mouse into the viewport and hit N to expand the right panel. The plugin should have added a tab to the right named SourceIO. Here, the plugin will list entity attributes that were stored in the map. If the selected entity has a model file attached, you can hit the Load Entity button to import it. SourceIO will then start importing the model and its materials. This works with multiple entities selected too. Just make sure to keep an eye on the console to see if the plugin runs into issues. If your computer isn't very powerful, or Blender becomes very slow, you should consider optimizing your scene. The more models you import into your scene, the slower Blender becomes. so it can be helpful to only import entities in an area of the map will actually be visible on camera. From here, you can start tweaking the lights and materials to truly adjust the scene for your renders and animation. I think REDxEYE is doing a great job with this plugin, so be sure to let them know how much you like it. And if this video was useful to you, be sure to like and subscribe.